Hello Internet, Parag Dhawan here. We are on part 2 of day 8 of Kaggle's 30-day machine learning challenge. In this video, we will see basic data exploration using pandas to get familiar with your data. First step in any machine learning project is familiarizing yourself with the data. You will use the pandas library for this. Panda is the primary tool data scientists use for exploring and manipulating data. Most people abbreviate pandas in the code as PD. You will do this with the command import pandas as PD. Click on the cell and run the cell. This will import pandas library and give it the alias PD. The most important part of pandas library is the data frame. A data frame holds the type of data you might think as a table. This is similar to sheet in Excel or table in SQL database. Pandas has powerful methods for most things you will want to do with this type of data. As an example, we will look at data about gold prices in Melbourne, Australia. In the hands-on exercise, we will apply some processes to a new data set which has home price in Lua. The example Melbourne data is at the path input Melbourne housing snapshot melb_data.csv file. We load and explore the data with the following commands. Saving the file path in the variable. So melbourne_file_path is a variable which stores the path of the file that is considered as a string. Then we are reading the CSV file using pandas read CSV function and storing it in a data frame Melbourne data. So by this statement you are creating Melbourne data frame. Then we will print the summary of data using data frames dot describe function. So Melbourne data is a data frame object and using describe function we are printing the summary. Click on the cell and run the cell. You will get the summary of data. Summary contains count, mean, standard deviation, minimum value, 25% of value, 50% of value, 75 percentile of value and maximum value of each of the labels or attribute present inside the data frame, which are numeric values. So for the numeric values, we have described the data frame, giving the count, mean, standard deviation, minimum value, 25 percentile data, 50 percentile data, and 75 percentile data, and maximum data inside the column. Interpreting the data description. The results show 8 numbers for each column in your original data set. The first name number, the count shows how many rows have non-missing values. Missing value arises from many reasons. For example, the size of the second bedroom wouldn't be connected when surveying the first bedroom house. We will come back to this topic of missing data. The second value is mean, which is the average. Under the STD is the standard deviation, which is the measure how numerically spread out the values are. To interpret mean 25%, 50% and 75% and max value, imagine sorting each column from lowest to highest value. The first smallest value is the mean value. If you go to a quarter way through the list, you will find the number that is bigger than 25% of the values and smaller than 75% of the values. This is 25% value, pronounced as 25 percentile. The 50 and 75 percentiles are defined analogously, and the max is the largest number. That's it for this video. Here we have seen how to import pandas library, how to read a data frame, how to describe the numeric attributes of the data frame, and description of count, mean, standard deviation, 25 percentile, 50 percentile, 75 percentile, and max.